Thousands of feet beneath the Earth's surface, in the most exotic locales, are precious metals, minerals, and stones. It is there that platinum, gold, silver, and diamonds are discovered. These raw natural resources only become more precious, more extraordinary, when touched by an artist's hands. Those delicate, magical hands are found at Ritani. Join us for an exclusive behind-the-scenes tour featuring Ritani's incredible team of artisans like jewelers, setters, and designers, all of whom make Ritani the premier bridal jewelry brand it is today. Each piece of jewelry starts out with a concept, a vision in the mind of the designer, which is then sketched, bringing a piece of Ritani jewelry to life.
When I design, I'm creating something that's unique and special for the Ritani customer. The designs start off with first maybe an idea from nature or from architecture.
Once we have our design on paper, we create a wax mold to make it come to life. There are two ways to model a piece of wax. The first is through hand sculpting.
I'm taking a block of wax and I'm creating basically a ring, carving it from scratch. And the reason why we use wax is so that it can be cast, can be melted out, and the metal can be poured in right in the cavity. And so it's a direct casting process.
The second is through CAD, our state-of-the-art 3D computer modeling software.
Ritani is unique because we are actually encouraged to experiment with different ideas. We're not limited to following a standard protocol. We really develop new ideas, and we have the benefit of using new processes. I would say that technologically, we're on the cutting edge of the industry.
Once perfected, the CAD designs are sent remotely to a 3D printer that produces a dimensionally accurate wax prototype of the piece of jewelry. Now we cast the wax into a master silver mold, which will be placed into hot rubber. Using a surgeon's knife, the original model is removed. The rubber molds are stored in Ritani's vaults in the event a customer wants the piece replicated in the future. We fill the rubber mold using a pressurized wax injector. And attach the wax models to a sprue, which is then placed in a heavy steel flask and poured over with investment or plaster. Once hard, the flasks are slowly heated in a kiln to 1400 degrees, and all of the wax residue has disappeared. Metal is placed into a crucible and is melted at 3000 degrees. Through centrifugal force, the molds are injected with platinum or white gold. Once cool, the plaster mold is broken away, revealing every detail of the original wax. Our bench jewelry experts are responsible for all of the main work involved in turning a raw casting into a piece of jewelry. The pre-polishing department removes all sharp edges and any extra unnecessary metal. For a third time, the piece will go back to quality control, where we meticulously check to see if there are any porosity issues or imperfections beneath the surface. At the same time, our gemologists search through hundreds of carats of diamonds to find the highest quality stones to complement the design.
As a quality control, I'm very, very strong about the quality. I will not accept anything that I don't like. I don't accept take anything that is lower than my standard.
The diamonds are laid out and fitted into the metal, which is carefully moved by hand to secure the stones, an art that takes many years to master.
This is the bright cut. When I raise the beads, it looks like a triangle or square.
Lastly, we round and clean the beads to ensure a refined shape. Every part of the setting must be polished again in order to provide a clean finish and then buffed to give it the proper shine. During the final QC check, every last I is dotted and T crossed. For this is the last official stop the jewelry makes before becoming one of the most meaningful symbols of a couple's life. The jewelry is then taken to final packaging and delivered to our retail clientele. As meticulous as we are about the quality of our product, we're equally concerned about the care and attention provided to our customers. With a yes, always mentality, we strive to give you, our customers, the quality, care, and service you deserve.
Something that we do try to do here at Ritani is accommodate special requests. Sometimes people are on a time limit. The wedding is that weekend, or the wedding is, you know, 10 days away, something like that. At customer service, what we'll do is we'll, even to the point of keeping someone still on the phone, we'll go and talk to our production manager or graphics or whoever we need to, say, can we put a rush on this? What do we need to do to make this happen?
For you are the foundation of our business. Ritani, a legacy of love.